Hey guys, in this video we will see mechanism of action of various anticholinesterase agents. We know that cholinesterase hydrolyzes acetylcholine present in synaptic space and terminates its action. Anticholinesterases are a group of drugs that inhibit this enzyme. As a result of inhibition, acetylcholine is not hydrolyzed and gets accumulated in the synaptic space, which in turn produces prolonged and more intense action on postsynaptic membrane. This is useful in certain diseases like myasthenia gravis, curare poisoning, etc. Now, based on duration of action, there are three categories of these drugs. Drugs with short duration of action like adrofonium and tacrine. Drugs with intermediate duration of action, which includes carbamates like neostigmine and physostigmine. And irreversible inhibitors, for example, organophosphates like serine, malathion, etc. Each group acts in different way. Let's start with the first category. Okay, so here we have active site of acetylcholinesterase. It has an esteretic site and an anionic site. Drugs with short duration of action like adrofonium binds only with anionic site. As long as the drug is bound here, enzyme is not available for hydrolysis of acetylcholine. With this type of drugs, binding is electrostatic and by hydrogen bond, which is weaker than covalent bond that we see with other drugs. Because of this, duration of these drugs is short, ranging from 2 to 10 minutes. Eventually the drug diffuses away and enzyme is ready for hydrolysis of acetylcholine. Now let's see the drugs with intermediate duration of action. This group of drugs interact with the enzyme in a manner similar to what we saw with acetylcholine. It occupies both the sites, then the enzyme breaks the drug and carbamylated enzyme is formed. As compared to hydrolysis of acetylated enzyme, which is very fast process, hydrolysis of this carbamylated enzyme is a very slow process, because of which inhibition lasts for 30 minutes to 6 hours. After this, metabolites diffuses away and enzyme becomes active again. Finally, we have organophosphates. They phosphorylate esteretic site and form very strong covalent bond. Reactivation of phosphorylated enzyme is extremely slow and takes hundreds of hours. On top of it, over a period of some time, this complex may lose alkyl group, which further strengthens the bond. This process is called aging and it makes enzyme completely resistant to hydrolysis. Time for aging varies among different organophosphates. Some drugs undergo aging within few minutes, whereas others take hours. Cholinesterase activity after inhibition by organophosphates is restored by synthesis of new enzymes. They can also be rescued before aging by cholinesterase reactivators, which is topic for next video. That's it for now. Keep sharing the knowledge. Thank you.